Hey guys, this is Matt Brunet, and welcome to Movie News Weekly, hosted by FilmBook. Now, before we begin, let's take a look at what we got in this week's news, which includes The Return of the King, Back to the Drawing Board, Russians Get to See Gay Josh Gad, a one-man Netflix show, Hollywood's Powerhouses at The Post, Samuel Jackson versus the British, Evergreen Shall See an Elephant Fly Along with Danny, Who Will Cause the Domino Effect, and The Flight to Pandora Will Be Postponed. So with that said, let's get things started.
He's bigger, faster, and stronger too. He's the first member of the Weekend Crew.
Kong Skull Island, the first part that would ultimately lead to the clash against Godzilla, immediately got into first place at the box office this weekend with more than $60 million. What helped with Kong's lead is how it is the only new wide-release feature that came out this week, while pushing everything else a step down. With that said, now Logan is just sitting in second place with a lot less than what it did last week with about $38 million. Meanwhile, Jordan Peele's Get Out officially hit its mark of making more than $100 million domestically at the box office by earning about $21 million during the weekend, while The Shack came from behind by getting $10 million. Following the rest includes the Lego Batman movie with almost $8 million, Before I Fall with $3 million, and Hidden Figures with almost $3 million. More like Out Back to Die, am I right? This movie spent 4 years for nothing. Tim Minchin, the composer and musician of the Broadway shows Groundhog Day and Matilda, announced on a message that the animated feature from DreamWorks Animation, Lorikins, is officially cancelled. He stated, "A couple of days ago, the animated film to which I've dedicated the last 4 years of my life was shut down by the new studio execs. The movie would have been a musical comedy about the Australian outback and would have starred Margot Robbie and Hugh Jackman." Minchin was also assigned to be the director of the feature along with Puss in Boots director Chris Miller. No official word came from either DreamWorks or Universal about the details to why the project got canned, but according to Minchin's message, it could relate to the new management from Universal. The project was originally scheduled for February 16th, 2018, and now the company has no movies planned for that year. Guess this would technically count as the most adult film Disney ever made, according to Russia. The Russian government officially stated that they will be releasing the live-action reboot of Beauty and the Beast in the country, but only in the condition that it would have a 16+ rating, which is the highest age rating for a family film to get. The controversy began when the Russian government was debating to ban the movie from the country due to Josh Gad's character, LeFou, being Disney's first that is openly gay. The Russians worried that it would have broken the rule in the country known as the gay propaganda law, which is to protect children from any homosexual imagery in order to, as they claim, protect traditional values. The law was signed by Vladimir Putin in the middle of 2013. Beauty and the Beast is still prepared to be released here this Friday. The movie is based on a one-man show by Roger Guinevere Smith, who is also starring in the film, which was inspired by real events where Rodney King was a huge help in stopping the three-day Simi Valley riot that happened in the early 90s that ended up killing 53 people. Smith has done one-man shows for about 20 years now, and he has been going on tour across the United States on Rodney King for 4 years, with his final productions in Oakland, Dallas, Los Angeles, and Portland. Smith will also be the executive producer of the film, along with Luna Ray Media and Buffalo 8 Productions. The release date would tie in with the 25th anniversary of the state court pleading not guilty for the videotape of four LAPD officers beating up King on April 28th. Believe me, the government versus the media is not a new concept. It has been going on for a while. Steven Spielberg has signed on to direct The Post, which will star Tom Hanks and Meryl Streep. The movie will tell the true story of the Washington Post in 1971, where editor Ben Bradley and publisher Kay Graham, played by Hanks and Streep respectively, have to fight the United States government in order to fight for the rights to publish the Pentagon Papers to the public. The movie will be financed and distributed by 20th Century Fox, while the international distribution will be done by Amblin Entertainment's associations like Universal and E1. Spielberg will also be producing the film with Amy Pascal, Christy McCusker-Krieger, Rachel O'Connor, Tim and Trevor White, and Adam Sumner. The director is currently both setting up the cast for The Kidnapping of Edgardo Mortana and working on the post-production of Ready Player One. The story of the Americans versus the British lives on. In an interview with Hot 97, Samuel Jackson questioned about why is it that most roles that required to be African-American ended up being taken by British actors. The most recent example of this is from Get Out, where the lead was played by Daniel Kaluuya. Jackson stated, "There are a lot of black British actors that would work in this country. All the time. I tend to wonder what would that movie have been with an American brother who really understands that in a way. Because Daniel grew up in a country where they've been interracial dating for 100 years. In Britain, there's only about 8 real white people left in Britain. So what would a brother from America made of that role? I'm sure the director helped. Some things are universal, but everything ain't." He also stated that a few reasons could be that British actors are cheaper than Americans and that producers believe that they're better trained. John Boyega went onto Twitter in response to the controversy stating, "Black Brits versus African Americans. A stupid-ass conflict we don't have time for." She's coming back to Tim to see some pink elephants. Evergreen is now in talks with Disney in order to be one of the stars of the live-action remake of Dumbo with Tim Burton as the director. While the plot is still kept under wraps, the new story is said to have more of a focus on the circus, and 4 human actors will be the main character along with Dumbo. If Green accepts, she will play as a trapeze artist who works for the main villain of the film. Disney has talked with several actors to join in the cast like Will Smith, Tom Hanks, and Chris Pine, but they all declined during the early talks. This will not be the first time that Green will be in a Tim Burton movie. She has already collaborated with him on his 2012 adaptation of Dark Shadows and recently appeared in Miss Peregrine's School for Peculiar Children. However, Evergreen will not be alone in this case. A couple days after the news broke out of Green's talks with Disney, Danny DeVito is also said to be in talks with the company to appear in Tim Burton's live-action reboot of Dumbo. If he accepts, then he will play as the owner of a small circus that ends up being owned by an evil big top circus owner. Like Evergreen, DeVito has been a familiar face in the works of Tim Burton, including playing as Oswald Cobblepot, aka the Penguin, in Batman Returns, and he even played a circus owner in Big Fish as Amos Calloway. Dumbo is one of the many animated features Disney made that they would like to turn into a live-action reboot, which they've already done with Cinderella, Maleficent, The Jungle Book, and soon, Beauty and the Beast. Picking up from a story from last week, Ryan Reynolds, producer and the star of the upcoming Deadpool 2, posted a picture on Twitter of a bunch of dominoes that spell the name of Zazie Beetz, which confirms that the actress will be playing as Domino in the sequel. Before the confirmation, there have been many rumors going around to who the character could be played by. Some of the suggestions include Janelle Monáe, Sophia Boutella, Stephanie Sigmund, Ruby Rose, Sylvia Hoek, and Mary Elizabeth Winstead. Beetz has recently been making many appearances on television, including Atlanta, where she plays as Vanessa, the Netflix series Easy, and in the drama Wolves. Deadpool will return to the big screen now with Domino sometime in 2018. Well, in the meantime, there is that new place at Disney's Animal Kingdom to get your Pandora fill. James Cameron announced that the sequel to the highest-grossing film of all time, Avatar, is getting delayed again. Originally, it was supposed to have a late 2014 release date, but then it switched to Christmas 2018, which it now seems like it will not happen. He stated in the Toronto Star, "Well, 2018 is not happening. We haven't announced a firm release date. What people have to understand is that this is a cadence of releases. So we're not making Avatar 2. We're making Avatar 2, 3, 4, and 5. It's an epic undertaking. It's not unlike building the Three Gorges Dam." Cameron also said that making the 4 sequels to the feature will take up approximately 8 years of his life to create. While there is no announcement to the new release date of Avatar 2, 3, 4, and 5 are said to be released on Christmas time of 2020, 2022, and 2023. But it will be possible that this could change. And that's all I've got for this week. Thank you guys so much for watching, and don't forget to head on down to film-book.com for all the latest movie and TV news, along with their columns on the box office and their theatrical release schedule. Also, you can follow them on whatever social media you'd like. And while you're at it, you can follow me on my YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter if you're more into stuff like animation, Disney, and my weird sense of humor. If you are watching this on YouTube, then hit that like button and come subscribe to us, and also leave a little comment on what you think on the news this week. If you are listening to this on a podcast on iTunes or any other podcast service, then don't forget to rate and review what you just heard. Tune in next time for another round of Movie News Weekly, and until next week, see you later, dudes!